So well-being essences. My friend, a kinesiology practitioner, and I had been working with our well, and the well had been giving me messages for about, well, for quite some time before I decided to make essences. And she wanted me to make essences for her kinesiology practice, and I didn't know how to make them. But within about 3 minutes, I had the guidance to make a miracle mist, which was to help people to trust and to remember that life is a miracle. And all the ingredients came to me very quickly. And the prayer of this is, divine loving spirit, archangels, angels, spirit guides, working for my greater good, thank you for guiding me for the greater good now. So that was the essence that came to me very quickly. And I was tested very strong on how to make it, but I didn't know how to make essences. And a few days later, I was buying a cupboard on eBay, a beautiful cupboard, and I rang the lady and I said to her, "Why, you've got such a healing voice. What do you do?" She said, "Well, I'm a backflorescence practitioner of 30 years. I'm just retiring." So she came and she taught me how to make the essences, which was incredible. And she gave me so much guidance and opened up a whole new world for me about the essences and how it wasn't particularly me making the essences, but the whole of the earth speaking through this flower, this bee, this crystal, to further the human consciousness. Now, the water that I'd been working with our well, we'd actually cleared the well with scrap metal, and we had a day when lots of people came and did ceremony, and at the end of the day, we all started to sing and chant. It was a beautiful day, and we all felt really relaxed, and I started to speak when we were all chanting, and I thought, I'm not going to speak. So I closed my mouth and then just carried on chanting. And then it came back again, and I felt I needed to speak. And the way that I was speaking was a different voice, and it was saying, "Thank you for setting us free. Thank you for letting us be." And it was saying that these beings were the dwellers of the wells, and that the angels, the nature spirits, and the humans are all connected in the heart, and that we can all connect to each other through the heart to further ourselves and heal ourselves. Now, when I finished speaking this, I had tears streaming down my face, as did many other people. And the feeling was of great joy and great love. And I felt like I'd connected with the heart of another being. I don't know if I actually channeled something, but I know my heart connected with this other being. And it was very, very beautiful. And soon after that, I really had a strong resonance with what I was doing with the water. And the fact that divine life force, which flows through all living things, is all-knowing, all-wise, and all-loving. And that comes through our bodies, into our bodies, which connect us to the whole of the earth, earth consciousness. When we realize that we are these two things, we start to reside in the heart. When the spirit comes into the body, we can start to live in miracle consciousness, where our needs are being met and we are guided to the medicines that we need for our highest good. And this is what I have come to feel. And to live more and more in that realm is a great pleasure and great bliss. Obviously, we're human and we have challenges along the way, but it's about steadying the balance, and nature is there to help us and nurture us into steadying the balance through our lives and bring great joy with its medicine and its fragrances and the vibrations that it has to offer. Now, essences are vibrational remedies. Now, when you make a vibrational remedy of a flower, you hold the flower in water in the sun for a couple of hours, and the energy and life force of the flower are drawn into the water, and then you secure that with vodka. That becomes a vibrational remedy that lasts for years to come. Now, when you spray that over you, it's the life force and energy that goes through you, actually through your body. And the essential oils, if I put them in a spray, are absorbed into the dermis, epidermis, and bloodstream and go into the physical body. Now, the prayers and intentions help with the conscious mind. So you're getting a triple healing going on. And it's helping you to focus when you spray them and bring in the prayers or to center yourself. Now, the other thing with the sprays, when you spray them over your head, the mist settles around you. And because the energy goes through you, it settles you out of the head and into the heart and then grounds you down into the earth. And it opens up an energy field around you, which is clearer. So the earth can speak to you more and spirit can speak to you more. And you can feel your body and the connection to spirit and the connection to earth. As well as my prayers which go in, which are my faith, and that is strongly in the pot, so that helps with people to connect with their own faith. You don't need any of this, you know, you can plug in yourselves, but these are beautiful medicines and vibrations of nature that are there to help us to find love, to give love, to heal ourselves, and to come into beautiful balance with ourselves and our environment, okay? So the first one that I was talking about is the Miracle Mist, which is this one, and I have a big client list of this one. I've got barristers, doctors that use it in their practices, marriage guidance counsellors, people that use it for their pets, therapists, yoga practitioners use it to further the meditational practice. So this is the Miracle Mist that helps us to trust and to remember that life's a miracle. And in a second, I'll come round and give you a little taste of that and see how you like it. The essential oils are high quality essential oils, and all the essences are essences that I've made. And I get like a instinctive guidance on what needs to go in each essence. The most popular one at the moment is the Rise and Shine, which is this one. Now this one has got the essence of the Phalaenopsis orchid, which is this orchid here, which is for unconditional love, to help us to love and be loved. It's also got the essence of raw diamond in. So the diamond is for the brilliance of the soul, and it's to help with endurance and you know, feeling sparkly. And pearl essence is to help us to let go of the emotions, the emotional layers that build up around us. So the intention on this one is thanking spirit and the archangels to allow us to let go of the past, to let go of self-sabotage, to let go of negative projections from family, from friends, from social groups and the media, bringing us into love, into now. Okay, now there's the Compassionate Buddha mantra in this one, which is Om Manapa Mahong, which I've been trained by different Tibetan lamas to bring us into the space of compassion. So this starts with compassion to self. And then when we have compassion to self, we can have compassion with others. And that's, you know, that's a main key, I feel, of Buddhism as well, is being gentle with ourselves, not judging ourselves, and coming into the heart with the way that we live and interact with the world. You know, loving ourselves is really important, as the flowers and the trees, they're in that perfect balance. So I'm going to come round now and give you a little blat of either the Miracle or the Rise and Shine, and you can see how that feels. But there's a lot of ingredients in this one. And it was because a lot of my friends and myself were having family, you know, friends, troubles, and they just needed a clearing and to come into empowerment with themselves. So I'll just come round and give you a little spray of that one. That was the Rise and Shine, and yeah, it's a beautiful smell, like fresh laundry. And that's the one that's going mostly at the moment, but the Miracle Mist is a beautiful one as well, to help us to come into the heart and to trust. And when that one's settled, I'll show you a bit more about that one, but I'll tell you a little bit more about the others. So the Bee Mist, this was the second one that I made, and it's a quite special for connecting with nature again. So here we have a swarm of bees in the tree. And my friend knew exactly what to do. We called him up. because I'd always wanted some bees in the garden. So he boxed the swarm, and my husband held the ladder. And then he got me to carry the box of bees home, which was an incredible feeling. 10,000 odd bees in a box in front of me, buzzing over my heart. It was an incredible feeling. And so when all the bees had gone into the box, which took about 2 hours, we'd made a hive. And when we got back, he said, right, bang the box and then all fall on the blanket. I said, I haven't got a suit on or anything. He said, no, it's fine. They'll be full of honey. They won't sting you. After the third bee went into the hive, all of the bees turned at exactly the same moment and made the same song, the same vibration, and slowly went in together, like collective consciousness. So I was making the essence of this in the rock crystal pot, and they were all wafting the pheromone out to all the other bees to say, this is home, sweet home. And they were leaving lots of pollen in the water. And the queen bee came over this area as well as they all went in. So this essence is called Home Sweet Home, just bee. And it was a second bee essence that I made. And the first one that I made, I'd made a year before. And it was made on May the 1st. And I went into the middle of these woods with my friend. And there was a stag and a doe just outside the woods, lit in gold. And the sun had risen, and the sun was in the antlers of the stag. It was the most incredible thing that I've ever seen. It was like something out of a Robin Hood movie. And so we knew by the symbols of nature that this was a very powerful essence, a really beautiful sign. So I went in and asked, well, the bees were quite quiet when I first went in, and I wondered if they were okay. I put my ear against the hive, and a little bee came out and landed on the top. And I put my finger next to him, and I said, is it okay to make the essence now? And he gave me a high five. I said to my friend, he's giving me a high five. He said, I know, I could see. Apparently they smell with their feet, so maybe he was checking me out, who knows. And so I asked for the bees to be able to bless the humans through this essence, and the humans to be able to bless the bees. And I called in Medicine Buddha and Green Tara and Great Spirit to protect and help the bees with their plight, and asked for a good little harmonious blessing for all of us. And then we went into town, and where we went, we found honeybees everywhere. And I was gifting them pieces of pollen to say thank you. Went down to the White Spring and in Glastonbury, and there was a little bee next to it having a drink of water that was running down the road. So I gave him a little bit of pollen that he went and had a little munch on. And when we got back to bottle the essence, a beautiful buzzard fell out of a tree and just whooshed off. And this little chocolate brown Egyptian cat turned up. It was absolutely beautiful, and they'd left a lot of pollen in the pot again. And so I bottled it there. And then that week I was taking it, and there was a beautiful, blissful feeling that I had from it, very like grail-like, and stress was just falling away. That week I stumbled across a guy called John Harding, who was an expert on bees, and he knew why they were dying and what to do about it. Now he has 300 hives, and he's monitored with dowsing how they like to live best. Now he says that if they are grown in horizontal hives, they get stressed, they get varroa, they don't give as much honey. And if they grow in hives that go upwards, like when they grow wild in colonies, they like to grow over underground streams that cross, and they like a certain orientation on the hive, and they can control their own temperature if they grow upwards. So he's discovered this, and he's advising the Houses of Commons as well with how the bees like to live. He's an incredible man, and I brought him up here a couple of years ago to do a talk, funny enough, on the bees, and that was really lovely. So that was a nice piece of synchronicity. And then I did a festival, and the bee essence just sold out. People were loving it, and I was asked to do the bee ceremony at Avebury. There were already two pots on the altar when I got there, and I sprayed everybody there. I told them about John. So John became part of the teaching and the blessing from the bees to help the bees as we were going along. So that was beautiful. And a couple of weeks later, I had a Tibetan Buddhist Lama come, and he gave me some beautiful blessing pills that the Dalai Lama had blessed for the medicines. And he wanted to take a pot of the bee medicine back to Nepal with him. And a couple of weeks after that, we helped a Lakota Sioux Indian to do a sweat lodge up in Derby. And he wanted to take a pot of the bee essence back to Pine Ridge Reservation in America. So within three weeks or so, the essence of the bees had gone across the world, which was absolutely beautiful. And funny enough, I started using Russian vodka, glacial vodka, to secure the essences. And straight after I'd made the bee essence, Putin opposed Obama about the bees in world media, which I thought was incredible, you know, to hear that as well, that it was in, you know, world news, that there was really serious stuff going on with the bees and it needed to be sorted. And I also heard that the harp machine was sending out a vibration which was interfering with the bees, and they were losing their way back to their homes. That was another trouble that they were going through, as well as the pesticides and the fact that they weren't given water a lot of the time. Now, apparently, according to John, the pesticides, when you stop using neonics, a lot of the farmers are using stronger pesticides. So there are other problems that go with cancelling out the neonics that he's also trying to work with. But the main thing is about getting the hives strong, the colonies strong, and allowing them to grow upwards rather than horizontally where they get stressed. So that gives you an idea of the synchronicity and the miracle consciousness of nature when you ask for the different blessings and nature opens up and gives you the most incredible synchronicity and helps along the way for whatever you ask for. But asking in the right way is also right, rather than asking, saying that you haven't got something and you want it. The best way is to thank the cosmos for bringing what you feel in your heart and feeling that you already have it, so that the universe or the cosmos can match that vibration and give it to you, rather than sending out a lack and then you get the lack back. So the universe, the cosmos, nature is abundant in all its forms. And we need to feel, well, we don't need, but when we feel that abundance within ourselves, then our needs are met, because that's our knowing, that's our truth. When we feel that bliss and that joy in our hearts, that's where we start to reside, and more, the more we can build on it. And, it, you know, that's the challenge of life, I guess. That's one of them anyway. So something else that I must tell you about in terms of the synchronicity. This was an essence that I wanted to make. The Minoan culture in Crete. Has anybody been to Crete? Yes, lovely. Well, you'll know the beautiful feeling that you get there and how held you feel and the smells. And it's just a beautiful place. And my husband proposed to me because of bees, and we went to Crete, and we found this place called Malia, which is actually a drinking town on the coast, but that's not where we went. We went to the temple on the beach, which was, we'd never felt so much peace there. Absolutely beautiful, harmonious place. And we found out afterwards that they found the gold bee pendant there, which is two bees kissing with pollen balls hanging off their feet. It's the most exquisite piece of jewellery that I've ever seen. It's in the museum at Heraklion. And they cannot reproduce this anymore with the craftsmanship that they had then. They made beautiful jewellery, clothes, pottery, and lived in harmony with the environment. They had no concept of war. The boys bull jumped and wrestled, but they had no concept of war. And they just were a beautiful race, from what I've learnt from them anyway, and what I feel when I go there. And the following year, after going the first time, we went back with some friends to do Minoan settlement tours, and we were giving blessings, and that was absolutely beautiful. And both years, when I went to Malia, I found a snake skin on the floor in the same place. So the following year, I really wanted to go back and make an essence, mostly because I'd had a shiatsu session, and I had asked, while having the session, when I was deep in meditation, why this temple had been taken by a tidal wave, because it's had such harmony and bliss there. And I was told that it had reached its zenith in harmony, so it had reached that maximum point of bliss, and then it had been taken by a tidal wave and made an essence of, if you like, in the etheric, and that I was part of that old civilization, and that I would be part of bringing that back, as many of us are tapping into things in the past to bring back the harmony through our medicines and our crafts. So I really felt a very strong resonance with this, and I cried. And that week and previous weeks, I'd had lots going on in my lungs. And that week on television, I was watching a program on telly about Crete and how it had been taken by a volcano and there was an eruption and ash. And I was watching the program and it was really hard to breathe. And I was having quite a strong problem at that point. And I could really not watch the program. It was too much for me. So then I went and had another shiatsu session, And I asked again, and I saw myself and others being taken by the tidal wave and felt what was going on. And it was, yeah, I wasn't quite sure what was going on, but then I realized that I had to make an essence of this place. So we were going to go back again and make an essence of the temple. And we had some people come and stay in our holiday cottage next to us, and they had friends who had family who had a villa in Crete. So we went and sort of swapped and stayed there. Incredible place, much nicer than our place. It was incredible. And so we stayed there. The night we got there was a full moon. So I made morning glory essence, and I knew that next day I had to go down to Malia and make the essence. It was a very powerful time. So we got to the temple, and I was looking for a snake skin. Couldn't find the snake skin that I'd found the two previous years. But what there was on the ground was a 12-pointed star. And I thought, well, a snake wouldn't make a 12-pointed star. What could do that? And my family were with me when I made this essence. My teenage boy was carrying the water, and my daughter was with us. And I walked into the middle of the 12-pointed star, and there was a termite coming out. So it was a termite colony. And now the termites are one of the best at living in community, as are the bees. So talking about archaic, ancient traditions and, you know, beings and communities of the planet, there were these termites with this 12-pointed star on the ground while I was hoping to bring in the etheric temple essence from the past. So it was perfect to ground it in. And so we've set the essence up, and then we went down to the beach, and I said, right, let's look for some temple pottery. So we were looking for temple pottery, and I turned down to the beach, and on the beach was this massive heart made of temple pottery. And it was like the earth giving its love while the essence was being made, and the temple giving its love while the essence was being made. And absolutely incredible. I've got a picture of it out here, I'll show you. When I went back to bottle the essence, there was a termite drinking some water out of the essence. And obviously, I was giving gratitude to the termites for their blessing. And they were helping themselves to a little bit of the water, which is a blessing in itself. So have a little look here. You'll be able to see the 12 pointed star on the back, just about, and the heart in the pebbles, which was an absolute blessing. So the whole family made that one, which is really special. And that one has been very helpful to help when things have been very hectic in the house, and it helps you to bring that temple energy in to calm things down and to help with your community again. And that's the other thing about the bee essence, that helps to solidify your community around you as well. After making this, I felt I had a much stronger, more helpful community. Although a lot about being supported is about the state of our mind and how we feel about being supported and how we feel we are being supported. It's our knowing that also brings back to us what we feel and what we attract to ourselves, our expectations. And well, that's what I feel anyway. So that was the temple essence. And where are we? Let's see, Avalon. So we've got the Divine Union, which has got the essence of spikenard in it, which is amazing. Mary Magdalene apparently rubbed spikenard on Christ's feet to ground him out and help him to get devotional. And this, I've got a plant in the garden of spikenard, which is very resilient, absolutely beautiful plant. And it grows through the hardest winters. And when you rub the root, it really smells really strong. Spikenard is a family of the valerian, and it's very hypnotic, and valerian is very sedative as well and pain relieving. But in terms of essential oils, it's very heady and transient. And so I've got the essential oil in this one as well, and that's a beautiful essence to help us to ground and to feel the divine union within ourselves and others. That's connecting with Christ and Mary Magdalene. The other is the Mist of Avalon. So this was made on a full moon lunar eclipse morning when everything was icy and the sun was just rising, and I asked for the energies of Avalon of the highest to jump into the pot for this one. It's an amazing space clearing mist, really clear. That's the picture of the morning that I took it, and that's a beautiful space clearing one. And here we've got the yew essence. This is the Compton Dundon yew at Glastonbury, which is a 2,000 year old tree. And I bottled this one at the time when the full moon was at its max. So it was a supermoon, and I managed to bottle it within the moment that the moon was at its totality. And when I went to bottle it, I rubbed my hands around the bark, and it was such a sensual, beautiful feeling. My whole body lit with the sensuality that I'd not, you know, not known from coming to make an essence. And it's very grounding. And when I made it, a friend who is very empathic, she could feel that the nature spirits really wanted to speak through this essence. And it was a very sensual, sensual essence, which, it's worth having a go at that one. It's quite a manly fragrance, the essential oils that I've used in that one. It's very empowering for men and women because it's grounding us into the earth and our arms are lifting up to heaven. That's the thing about the trees, with the spirit of the trees. When you can merge with the tree energy, you become like a torus of spirit flowing through into the earth and then back round, and it brings you into the heart again, what we were talking about earlier. So meditating with the tree essences is a beautiful, powerful way to connect with tree energy and to gain strength and wisdom and balance and a sense of purpose, and to extend our own beings into the wisdom of the cosmos and bring you into the heart as well, strengthening. And it's got the antiseptic properties in there as well. But it's a beautiful synergy oil to help you to sleep and to de-stress wherever you are, whatever's going on for you. It's a beautiful calming one. And the green Tara mist. Now, I've been, like I said before, I've had a few empowerments from Tibetan Buddhist lamas. Green Tara was absolutely amazing. When I left after a 3-day retreat, I went to the sea and I drew a heart around me and started to do the mantra. Green Tara is for heart healing, relieving suffering, removing obstacles, and relieving pain. And she is fast to come and help. She is incredible. And I started doing the mantra, and within a couple of minutes, there was a tickle under my left foot, and a little baby crab had come up under my left foot. Tickle under my right foot, a little crab had come up under that foot. And then a tickle on my right foot, and a little tickle. This fish was sat on my right foot, and then a fish was sat on my left foot. I couldn't believe it. I was overwhelmed. I just had tears falling out my eyes. It was just such a beautiful feeling. Now, Tara, these essences on the back of the leaflet, the Tara mantra is there that you can do yourself and see how you feel yourself when you do it. She is incredible, very fast to come, quick to help and heal. I had a huge horsefly bite in my groin and I couldn't sleep. After doing the mantra, I was asleep very quickly. She's very quick to come. But when you spray this essence, 108 mantras went into the actual essence. So when you spray it, every little particle that's in the mist has 108 mantras in it. So the prayer goes thousandfold. So this is a really beautiful one for heart healing, removing obstacles, relieving suffering. And when Tara was alive, apparently, she did so much good work to bring people to Buddhism that one of the Rinpoches at the time said, maybe you'll be born as a man next time and you can come back as a bodhisattva. And she said, well, why do I have to come back as a man? So she was one of the first female deities of the Buddhist pantheon, which is lovely. And the other one is the Medicine Buddha. So that's made with the same idea as the Tara. This has got 108 Medicine Buddha mantras in it. If I can find it, there it is. There. So this is Tata Om Bikonsi, Ma Bikonsi, Raza Samogate Soha. I had the biggest healing of my life with the Medicine Buddha mantra 3-day retreat. And that's a very powerful one as well. Absolutely beautiful. And that again, the mantra is on the back of the leaflet, which helps people to do that for themselves and for their friends and family. And children are great at doing them as well. And it just brings fast relief for so many things. Now there's Dove of Peace, that's made with the essence of our doves when they were asleep. And that's a beautiful one. But the whole thing about the essences and the water, like I said, it's about helping us to come into the heart and to release our fears. Because when we think that we're running on our own steam, just us, when we haven't got the support, that's when we're in our ego space, our ego mind. And then it's hard for us to get the guidance that we need, because we think it's just us. But when we come back to the heart and the flow of everything that's trying to help us, then we get our guidance to the herbs and the flowers and the people that we need to meet or the things that we need to do. And that's very special. So that's there for us all the time. And you don't actually need anything to get there yourself if you can just keep talking to yourself on that level and coming into the heart. that's the most incredible thing that we can do, really, and how to be. So has anybody got any questions at the minute? Yeah.
I'm very in tune with flower essences, and I'm doing the Sue Lilly's course, the mandala essences. But my other life, I work in the NHS. So I'm very curious how you managed to get across, you said at the beginning, to you've got GPs interested in some of the ones, the early ones you mentioned. So how do you do that?
I've had a dementia doctor who can't actually use them in the health system, but she uses them herself and as room fragrances in places that she goes, so, you know, in that term. But also I'm working with a lady in Australia who's actually, well, not her, just the whole body of people are proving that vibrational remedies are working, and they are using them in the health service out there, as well as the cannabis sativa. So they're getting a lot of scientific evidence together, and it's already been proved, and it's already going into the health service out there. I'm working with her. I'm supposed to be going to see her next year. And we're hoping to bring more of that scientific evidence across, and somehow we do feel strongly that it is going to start opening up. It already is in certain fields, but it's just slowly, and it depends. Different towns have different acceptances, so we've just got to watch this space and just keep slowly infiltrating and desiring it to go in and knowing that it will and trusting that it will, and it is starting to go in. I'm also working with an ex-para ex-military guy, and he's helping me make the essences, and it's helping him. He's already got an incredible affinity with flowers and the spirit of flowers, and he works in an amazing way. He's actually teaching me a lot as well, and he is also taking the cannabis ointment that I make, which is amazing for arthritis, fibromyalgia, eczema, psoriasis, painful joints and swellings. That's also going out to the people that need it. I've got 80 testimonials for that one, which is helping people with the physical pains and the skin problems that they've had going on. I sell that at fairs all over the country, and it's going really well online now through word of mouth. But he's helping to sell and make quite a lot of this stuff now, which is amazing. And I'm in the Just For Her Military Personnel magazine, so the ointments are in there, and the Miracle Mist is in there, and I've got guys that have been using that for helping with their stress and PTSD, and so it's starting to get there in my field, but in other people's field there are people that are more in the field, so I'm learning. And I've made a connection yesterday with a lady who's working with people in the military that are working out what does help with PTSD, so I want to talk more with her. She's talking about in America, they're doing scientific research on what is actually helping. And so we're slowly getting more information come to get into the health service and, you know, all these areas that really need it. Although there's a lot less help than there should be in terms of alternative therapy, it's beginning. And if we can hold it in our hearts that it's happening faster, that would be amazing. But yeah, we're getting our guidance to get in there. We'll have to talk more afterwards because there's a lot of connections with coming to the fore, and maybe you can help with that as well. But there are lots of rules and regulations about getting things, you know, mainstream in, so it's just all starting. Yeah, but yeah. So the flower essences are proven in many areas of the world to actually help people with emotional problems, and there's a lot of scientific research going on to prove it, and it's very exciting. What's happening now, you know, we're at the beginning of this, but in 5-10 years it will just be mainstream. I'm sure, you know, it's starting to pick up, and a lot of hospitals in America do use them in many different ways, so, and I'm sure they do here, but it's just the build up. Yeah. Anybody else, any questions? The heart and vibration. From what I feel, I've done a lot of work with Tai Chi, Shaolin, Kung Fu, and I'm a Feng Shui practitioner as well. I studied with a master from Hong Kong. 200 applicants applied and 10 of us passed. It was really full on intense, and that was from a master from Hong Kong, so he really knew his stuff, and I was practicing for about 5 or 6 years. So I got to understand quite a lot about the vibration of buildings and our bodies and spaces and places and plants, and what can increase the vibration and what can decrease the vibration, and what's already held in the earth or held in our body from memory, which the vibration remedies can really help with. When you walk into a wood and it's all beautiful and rainy, and the good vibration that you get when you walk in and then you walk out, you feel much more positive. The positive vibration is, you know, atmospheric. It's in atoms and ions in the air that you're breathing in and your skin's breathing in. And life force is more potent in nature, as we know, whereas when you come out into, you know, concrete cities, and the life force is a lot less and nature's not flowing so strong, and we become cut off from the good vibrational remedies that nature has to give us. And so if people can't get to those places of nature, the essences can help to bring the vibration of nature to them. And it's a great way to use the vibrational essences to spray them over you, because like I say, it's like going for a walk in the woods, where you're actually getting the resonance come through you, into you, over you, creating a change in your space and in your own emotional body and your body as well. So, you know, for people that live in high-rise flats, for instance, they might be very cut off from nature, but these medicines can help them to feel that beauty and in on a conscious and a subconscious level, and having the prayers and the faith in there as well, that can help them to find that vibrational remedy. But I was sat outside my house one day in my garden, and I was looking at a fly landing on a piece of chicken shit. And then I looked at a bee landing on a flower. And, you know, the vibration of different beings and the way that they live became very apparent to me. You know, bees eat flowers and make honey. Flies eat crap. And, you know, they're completely different vibration. And we feel that. You know, we don't want flies around us, but... Oh, yes. I'm just focusing on hoping that you're getting my message. Yeah, I'm feeling in my heart that you're all getting the message, even though you might not hear me very well. Okay, I'll talk louder. Thank you. Thank you for that. So, in terms of vibration, people say, what's vibration? You know, you got dog poo, you got rose with rainwater on it. You know, these are two very different vibrations. They're different smells. But, you know, if you didn't smell it, you'd still feel the vibration. And when you walk into somewhere like that's really not got a very good feel, you know it, you feel it in your body. And that's also another thing about water. Water holds the memory. We're 70% water. And the memory, and we feel the resonance of what's near us, because the water has a memory. And we also, like the ocean has the waves going out to the shore to feel where it's going. We feel with the water that's in our body. We can also pick up the memory of what's around us through our own body. And we can feel if things are good for us or bad for us. And, you know, we're much more empathic than we think when we allow ourselves to be. We can tell ourselves so much more. And if we can settle into our hearts, that's where our true wisdom is and where we can get our true guidance. I did a meditation on the heart once, and I went and I settled on asking what my mother's love was. And I felt this huge, huge love, absolutely massive. And then my child and my husband and friends, and then the life force that's in everything. And the strength of the love got so strong that I could have gone. It was pulsing so, so profoundly that it was just incredible. And then I thought about someone that didn't like me very much and how I felt about them. And it was just a measure of love. It was like a smaller amount of love, and it made me have more compassion for them and our relationship. And I feel that when we're in our head, it's so easy to judge ourselves and others. But when we come down into the heart, it's just a measure of love, a large amount of love, a small amount of love. And when it's a small amount, it just makes you want more. It doesn't feel quite right. So, yeah, in terms of vibration, our hearts got the guidance that we need. And it's important to use our heads as well for the logic aspect, but, you know, the two together. But there's a lot of research on that too. But so vibration really, I feel, comes in when we're born, and we get that connection of the soul through the heart. And that's when we can start feeling, you know, we start feeling the vibration of what we like and what we don't like. I think a lot of it is to do with the heart. That's how we feel vibration. And that connects us to life force, where the life force comes in to our body at the beginning. I know the umbilical cord is a big thing too, but I think heart is a massive portal for life force and vibrational upliftment. So the more we can live in our hearts and open our hearts and start being aware of how open our hearts are and what opens our heart, what gives us joy, what makes us feel love, what makes us feel loved, what makes us want to love. You know, this is where nature can help, because nature's so good at that. Nature's there just wanting to love us and gift us. And yeah, there are challenges with nature. You know, nature can be harsh, but at the same time, it's all got its own balance and its own karmic cycle. And, you know, we need to go through the karmic things that we need to go through to enlighten ourselves as well. You know, sometimes we have to go through really hard things to shift karma and move forward towards enlightenment, but it's the path that we need to take, and that's where nature can help us with all that. Now, would people like to do a meditation to feel the vibration? Yes.
I've been making flower essences for about 25 years or more, and there's one point that I wanted to make which I feel is relevant, and it's this, that as you, you know, I usually make them, you know, and they're delivered as in your mouth with a dropper. And of course, when you take one dose, you know, the resonant frequency of your body adjusts to accommodate that higher frequency as it enters into your energy field. But when you do that once, your energy field can quite quickly drop back down to its ambient level. But if you keep taking the flower essence, and this is my point, regularly, perhaps up to 7 times a day, you know, your energy field happen to continually upgrade to accommodate this new frequency. After a while, gathers an energetic momentum of its own, and that momentum gathers as the days go by. So if you carry on at that increased dose, after 4 days, perhaps, the effects can be so much greater than if you just use it occasionally. Do you know what I mean? And I think that's, in order to get the maximum benefit, I think that's a very important point.
It is an important point, definitely. But there's also something else going on with a lot of these as well. It's the intention that people are getting it quickly as well. My intention is that people are getting it pretty much instantly. So when they're feeling it going into their bodies, my intention with the prayer as well is that they're getting that spirit connection and the earth connection with their hearts, and they're getting that connection as well. It's completely right what you're saying about holding the vibration and lifting the vibration more and more each time you take it, because it's a very subtle thing. It's affecting the subtle body, and that's so true. It is. It is. And it goes deeper and deeper and deeper. Yeah. Yes, that's very true, yeah. And sometimes when it needs to be more. That's very, very good point. Very good point. And, yeah, thank you very much. So with the vibrational remedies and the whole point of being in the heart, we can do a little meditation now just to help to guide us, to help us to feel that resonance in ourselves and that guidance that we can get. So if we can get straight back, and feel the connection with earth, with your feet, or with your bum on the ground. Straighten yourself and breathe in through your nose into your belly. Fill your belly with air. We just do 3 breaths to start with. Breathe in deep and breathe out. Breathe in through your nose. Breathe out through your mouth. Breathe in again through your nose and out through your mouth. Okay, so now if you can feel divine, loving life force, archangels, angels, spirit guides working for your highest good around you and coming through you now, that life force, feel it coming through you, filling your body up even more with this beautiful, loving, all-knowing wisdom, like a big, thick treacle light filling your whole being. Breathe in that light and become that eternal life force even more, all-knowing, all-wise, all-loving, And now open up between your feet and send that life force down into the earth, into the center of the earth, connecting you to the earth. Like, feel like a tree, sending your roots down into the earth. And take that beautiful life force down into the center of the earth, grounding you. Give love to the earth for all that it offers you every day, the support that it offers you for so much of your life on every level, physically. The support and the love. Feel the connection. And breathe into that connection with earth. Our bodies connect us to the whole earth, earth consciousness. So the spirit flows through us and our body is connecting us to the whole earth. And when we feel these two things connect, we reside in the heart. Now feel your heart, breathe into your heart. Let yourself just settle into the heart. Breathe into your heart. Breathe out and breathe into your heart. Feel the connection of spirit and body. This is where miracle consciousness resides, in the connection to spirit and body, heaven and earth, physical and spiritual. Here we reside for the highest good, in joy and bliss. And feel gratitude. Feel yourself like the Taurus, the spirit coming down into the earth. And now bring the earth energy up to the heart and just reside in the heart, feeling completely balanced in physical and spiritual union in the heart. Beautiful gold ball of light around you as you're held in this beautiful space on earth, in space and time. Gratitude is a great place to start each day. Being thankful for all that you have. And being thankful for being guided to all that you need and desire. Bliss. Feel the bliss. Let everything else fall away. Just feel the love and the bliss and the good vibration of nature within you. And I'll just come round now and spray you with a little bit of the lavender and amethyst healing essence. Okay, if you just start to wriggle your toes a little bit and breathe and relax and just feel that you can hold that space wherever you are, in time, wherever you are, grounded and in your heart. Nature in your heart. And the more we can be in the heart, the more we can feel the joy that the plants and the flowers and the bees and the earth are giving us and each other, the humans in between, residing in the space in between. We are nature. We are the miracle consciousness too. Okay. Okay. So just to let you know about the essences, when you make a flower essence, the flower goes in the water for a couple of hours in the sun and the life force goes in. When you make it out of the crystals and the gems, 6 hours, the essence is created. And it tastes either like silica from the crystal or a metallic from the gold or the silver that you use. And it's the vibration that's captured, and that really is the thing that goes through us, either when you take the drops or when you take the sprays into your being. And it is subtle, but is very profound and, yeah, exquisite. And I'd just like to say thank you for coming and listening. And if you've got any more questions, if anybody has. Yeah?
No, I just want to say thank you very much. I'm actually a couple of years ago here after, so I do a lot of campaigning against GMOs.
It was you! I recognise your face.
We were absolutely right down there, you know, it's just a mess. Every bit of energy had gone out. Just fighting the Monsantos of this world is not very nice.
No.
And spending the afternoon with this lady, I've never felt, you know, a bigger sort of like transformation from bad into the heart, is what you were saying. Okay. You know, so lovely to see you again. I still have the spray that you
Divine
gave me.
Love.
Divine Love. Yeah. And I use it every day. Two years I've had it. It's still going.
You're saying it like a magic
pot. She's not failing in this offer. Well, no, it's very special.
No, and I've been telling people that you go out to front lines demonstrating. You're doing amazing work, and you go to really awkward, really nasty, violent places. And yeah, it's lovely what you're doing, taking the essences out there. So love it you've come back. Well done, thank you. That's lovely, thank you. So have a look on the website as well. There's lots of testimonials for all the different essences and essential oils, and I mean the essences and what they how they're helping people with lots of different things. And the ointments as well, like I say, for arthritis, fibromyalgia, eczema, psoriasis. I just can't believe what people are coming back with. I've been making the miracle ointment for 5 years now. But with all that ingredients in there, it's helping people with skin problems and pain. It's not actually numbing. It's anti-inflammatory, antispasmodic, antiseptic, antimicrobial. So have a little try if you've got anything going on, or if you just want to feel how softening they are. The miracle ointment's this one. And there's a burn one here as well, if you've got any sunburn. This one's aloe vera, cannabis, and lavender. And, I've got lots of testimonials for those over the back, and they're in the Military Personnel magazine. But, so in terms of gratitude, I'm overwhelmed to be able to have people want to listen as well to what I've been doing, because it's been amazing. And yeah, so the plants and the trees and the bees, yeah, they've got some powerful medicine, this whole earth. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, our very own Juliet.